Hi, I'm Lucy Ravitch from kidsmathteacher.com, where we take everyday things and turn them into hands-on math activities. Yay! Today for Math Activity Thursday, we're working with 100 charts. You might have seen some of these around, but it's easy to find one off the internet where you can print for free. This one came from superteacherworksheets.com. One of the first things you can do with a 100 chart is fill it in. This blank one came from homeschoolmath.net. In their worksheet section, they have a lot of free worksheets that are great for math. So let's start. And your kids might start to notice this pattern and know that they go, so you can actually do 31, 41, 51. You can start going down the line if you wanted to. They can fill it in how they like as long as they're making sure that they do it correctly. And there we have our completed chart. And once you have your chart, you really want to congratulate your child for filling it in correctly and as neatly as possible. And then you can do some fun activities with it. Now that they've filled out the chart, you can talk to them about odd numbers and even numbers, how all the odd numbers follow the columns and all the even numbers also follow each column. And you can color them in if you like. Did your child enjoy doing this activity? I hope so. It's great to see the odds and evens throughout the 100 chart. Hopefully your kids will enjoy math, and if they're ready, they can start doing the multiples and seeing the different designs that the multiples give us. With this worksheet, we're going to do the multiples of 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10 on this worksheet. And with your child, you might want to say the numbers as you say them, 42, 44, 46, and say each of the numbers. Now we'll do the fours. Now we're going to do multiples of 6. Multiples of 8. And 10s are pretty easy. So in one chart, we can see all the multiples of 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Now we'll do the multiples of 3, 6, 9, and 12. And your students might start to recognize that there's this pattern of going down the line too. That 3 and then 12 and then 21, how it makes a line. And then with this pattern, you can see that each time it jumps a whole 30 to 60 to 90 for it to be in the same column. Next, we'll do the multiples of 9. And let's do 12. There you have it, the multiples of 3, 6, 9, and 12. And now we just have 5, 7, and 11, the prime numbers to do. And your kids might start to understand there's a pattern, so they can actually, they know all of these are multiples of 5. And go down this column. And then go down this column if they wanted to. Or you can go across. So in this one, you can see that it jumps a whole 70 to get to the next one down. Then we do 11s. So with all of these charts, we can see the different multiples of the numbers. After you've done all of these different multiples, it's fun to just see the different designs that are in them. Does your child have a favorite design? I know some of my kids struggle with the nines, and it's interesting to see that each of these multiples of nine, the digits actually add up to nine. That's a little math trick. So nine and then 1 plus 8, 18 is 9. 2 plus 7 would be 9. 3 plus 6 would be 9. It's just a little trick you can show your kids. One of the activities you can do with your number chart is picking a number and seeing the numbers above, below, and the different sides, and talking with your children about their orientation and how much more or less are they. You could also cut out them into strips and line them up to be a number line, and then do different activities with that long string of number line. I hope you had a great time with this Math Activity Thursday on 100 Charts. I want to thank you for subscribing, and also, if you can, leave in the comments below what you thought of this activity. Do you do something different with your 100 charts? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.